atrocious that the PPPs, the loans that have been available, have not come back to our communities. This $1 billion will come back to our communities.
New York State Assemblymember Nathalia Fernandez, with over a dozen business owners from Burnside Avenue who faced enormous challenges this year with no immediate end in sight as they now look for rent relief provided through the latest federal stimulus package now in Albany.
It's been really tough, you know, like just trying to hang in there and, keep pushing with everything that's going on after being looted and the virus and the shutdown.
Still in business here across the street from where their old store was looted over the summer during a George Floyd rally, others have not been able to make it, as seen in some of the boarded up storefronts.
It's hard, but, you know, we're just keeping our head up.
And that's what Pierina Sanchez is working to do for Moselle and roughly 250 other businesses that line Burnside Avenue.
What we have seen is inordinate amounts of closures. You can see that if you just walk down Burnside Avenue. And in addition to that, we have not seen a requisite response from the government, from the city, from the state, from the federal government.
Sanchez shared she is closely watching Assembly Bill 3190 meant to invigorate economies that suffered during the pandemic. While Moselle reopened, she wants others to do the same, and she's not alone.
We both put in $1 billion to help get businesses some relief, rent relief. This past year in COVID, they haven't gotten anything. So this is really, really important that we make sure that this gets into the final budget proposal and that businesses can get the rent relief that they desperately need.
Also there, Ahyoung Kim from the Asian American Federation, who says Korean-owned businesses in the Bronx have also been affected.
We realize there really isn't anybody that's speaking up for them and their needs. So they have to call us or they have to come all the way to Queens to have a conversation about this issue. And I thought it was important for me to be here.
As you can see, many businesses out here, businesses that are hoping to get the help they need to stay afloat. For BronxNet, this is Arlene Mukoko.